And
Redemption.
Which one was this?
This is
Beyond the Boundary.
Beyond the Boundary.
Alright. Well.
Katana.
We just started.
We just started. Alright, review for Katana.
Discussion, you mean?
Discussion? Yeah, review is going to be later. Alright.
The official non-spoilery review.
So where do you want to start?
Let's see. Where does one start with Beyond the Boundary?
I would say with characters. That was what it had best going for it.
Yes. Characters.
The interestingest hell characters.
They're great. And I think it's great because they only had like a few characters. Looking at it now, kind of.
There was only.
It's not a huge cast.
There was four main ones, and then you had, what, six side characters?
Yeah, exactly. It wasn't that huge of a cast, so like. Character development was extremely easy since. You know? Not really spread out.
Was there really development?
I would say.
I can't really think of any character really developing.
What?
Well,
before
okay,
I call
no.
her Bespectacle Beauty,
no,
Kuriyama.
Well, yeah, Kuriyama did, definitely.
That's kind of obvious.
Yeah, but, like, none of the other mains, I would say, why can't I hook this guy?
Punk?
Yeah, I missed.
Okay, I'll distract.
So, who was your favorite, then, out of all the characters? Screw you.
The one who didn't die. let's see.
That's all
of
them.
Okay, well, favorite character out of all of them? I don't know, I just like Kanbara. Or Aki.
Aki? So, the main character.
I enjoyed him. Yeah, the main character. Well, you could argue that there were two main characters in the series.
Yeah, but protagonist then.
I forgot the word. There's a word for it for like two protagonists. Like, I don't know.
This is an English class. I don't care.
Yeah. I will say, in terms of character, I felt like Sakura got shafted.
Sakura?
Like her kind of story thing.
Yeah, again.
Like, she kind of was. She was played out like she would be a big issue, but then she was kind of.
It was just kind of to get the main plot going, which I didn't like.
Same. It felt like. Yeah, she.
So
she
are
was
we assuming
that's
the
best way.
Have or have not watched? I can't help you.
Yeah, no, whatever.
Are we assuming the people have or have not watched this?
This is spoiler filled, and we are going to assume that. People have watches.
I've watched. Okay. So, out of the three kind of arcs that they had during this one season, hers was only kind of just to play on, to power up the main bad guy.
Right. Fujima.
Yeah.
Fujima.
So, I quite liked her arc.
Sakura's?
Yeah.
Especially, yeah, same.
Especially in the beginning when they're fighting the Hollowed Shadow.
Mm-hmm.
I really like that.
Although, there are times where her voice acting did kind of bother me.
Oh, I didn't notice.
It's just a little too much, though.
Good
dub voice acting.
That got
be
better,
clear.
Though. As when she got more emotion, that is. Speaking of voice actors, my favorite character definitely Mitsuki, whose name I can finally say.
Mitsuki. Yeah, no.
I just like her character, especially when she was talking to Aki.
Yeah, because she is the perfect type of kind of smart ass. A likable smart ass.
A likable smart ass. Yes.
Also known as a tsundere, I guess.
Was she? Well.
I describe that as tsundere. Not all tsunderes have to be physical as well.
Oh, do they not?
Hmm.
So much for that definition.
So, segueing from Mitsuki, because that made me remind. Hello. Yeah. The comedy of it was so fluid.
I know.
It, like.
And that's probably why the characters were. That's probably one reason why it was so good. Was characters
yeah.
were nice, really good comedy.
the comedy was extremely fluid. There wasn't any kind of breaks in between. It was from one laugh to another kind of thing.
Until you get to the end, and then it just gets all... Well, no, I wouldn't say it was completely, was completely serious at the end there.
No. So yeah, comedy was great. It made me, it didn't actually... It wasn't... Comedy was a good kind of addition to the series. It wasn't something that overshadowed anything. It blended nicely.
You know, except for that one episode where they're fighting the plant or the fruit, Yomu. And they have to do an entire dance routine for it.
That was great. The idol sequence.
Oh my god.
That was fucking great. Dead? What? How are you not dead?
Because I'm pro.
Uh-huh. Oh, that's not his neck. That's his ass.
Dang it, I gotta get out of here.
Yeah, the comedy was extremely fluid. Idol scene was nice.
Especially with the mother. I felt like those scenes were really good.
The mother. Oh, her! Don't mention the mother!
Wait, do you have something against the mother?
The mother is like the reminder that there's still a lot of unanswered things.
Wait, yeah, that was something that I never did in the beginning. Everything was more or less answered. And then in the very last episode...
Yeah, like, well... Yeah, true.
And compared to the end, everything was getting answered.
Kind of the second half was...
Kind
of downhill.
Or third.
Second, third. Third. No, it's... What? Third. What? Second, third?
God damn. There were three...
Last third,
yes. There were total of three sort of arcs.
Story arcs, yes. Also, I'm surprised you haven't died yet.
I am too. You just jinxed it. Where is it?
Well, now that the bad thing has been mentioned, kind of the plot holes that was left.
All the plot holes.
All the plot holes left. Probably not gonna mention any. Mention any that I don't list out. The old man of the Nase family?
Oh yeah, him never being mentioned. Was he actually...
Who is he? Who the hell is he?
I think he was like the leader of the Nase family, but...
Yeah, we got the impression that he was kind of like the top dog of the Nase family. But it was never specified what... Like, is he a spirit? Is he a yo? Like, what the fuck?
He would be part of the Nase family, so he would be normal. My issue is, very end, Hiromi said, like, pretty much just said, screw you, which means, does he actually have any power?
I don't know. But here's the thing, you said that his Nase family, he had to be human?
Yeah.
Izumi's half.
No, Izumi took in a Yomu.
Oh, right, yeah, no, she sealed it, no.
Or something, I don't know, that was...
Yeah, it seemed like... Rather, she was born with it, she kind of, like, sealed it within her.
Yeah, same with,
It kind of gave up that impression.
Fujima.
Okay. Alright, well, clarifying that. But, okay, moving on from that, the old man, the father of Akihito.
Yeah, really, I would have loved to see him. Unless he's dead.
True. But still, anything, kind of backstory, there's no mention of him, other than, the Yomu side of him is from his father.
Yeah.
That's the only mention of him. Nothing else is mentioned. Unless I'm mistaken, right?
No, nothing.
Yeah. The mother is also kind of part of plot hole because she mentions that our two protagonists, Kuriyama and Akihito, is not special. Well, other than being protagonists, why aren't they special? Or why are they special? That wasn't answered. Also, her eyes...
Yeah, I was about to bring that up.
Went from, like, red to blue at one scene.
Did they start out blue, or did they start out red?
I don't know. I didn't notice until, like... I don't know what point, but... Oh, there you go, finally. At the last time.
Dang it. I was on a roll, too.
Yeah, you were. At the last damn time. Yeah. There are a lot of things unanswered. And for those of you who don't know, there is a kind of Beyond the Boundary sequel that is a movie.
Live action movie? What? No, there wasn't.
No, not a live action. Huh?
Oh, it wasn't on live
action? No, the movie acts as a sequel to it. So it follows up straight after this.
Okay.
It picks up right after Akihito finds Kuriyama at the roof. It goes right after that.
I really wish they would just kill off characters. I really do. When Akihito died, or we thought he was dead, I would have really been happy had it ended there. Would have been a great dramatic ending.
Right. There were a lot of things that were just... Ah! I'm dead, whatever.
Oh, well, this seems familiar.
There were a lot of things at the end that were done that were extremely kind of cliche.
Only a little.
Tad bit, maybe. It was kind of questionable. A lot of things.
I just had no clue what was going on in the last
Exactly, last
bit.
two episodes was kind of incoherent. Alright. Where were we?
Incoherence.
Incoherence.
Last two episodes.
Yeah, the plot was just
Like,
everywhere.
it's not the plot. Dang it. I wish that hadn't been spilly frames. Is
I
it?
don't know if it's something that if we watch it again, we'll maybe understand it, or it's like something that
I
is
doubt it.
extremely difficult. Like the whole dimension thing.
The dimension
The
thing.
bubble.
Yeah, the bubble I couldn't really get.
Yeah, neither can I. Woo!
Because the dimension thing I at least understood from the Hollow Shadow. Kill it, please.
I can't, not in time. Was right there. You suck.
Dang it. So.
I was grabbed. I was grabbed. Okay. There. Okay.
But yeah, I understood the whole dimension thing. I didn't understand where the core of it was.
Exactly.
Because.
God, that was
Or
confusing.
how he. Or. What was the Akehiko that she created?
That was his Yomu side.
Why was it up there? A
Because
very
his
question.
Yomu side
Why did
is the
they
Beyond Boundary.
merge?
Huh?
Why did they merge when he just suddenly showed up there? Also, plot convenience that he was even at the same spot as Akihiko.
Yeah, it. The ending didn't do the series justice, in my opinion.
Nope.
I felt like that could have been done a whole lot better.
Went for.
However, the series itself is still amazing.
Ending killed it for me.
I'd still say the ending kind of made it blow, in my opinion, but it's still something that's worth watching.
In fact, you could take the good choice and just stop after the, what is it, eighth episode, ninth episode?
Sure you can, but if if it's someone like me, I'd have to watch the rest of the series, knowing the fact that there are other episodes.
Yeah, I would do the same.
That would just kill me. Also, I kind of lost where you were. Did you go?
Over here.
That. Okay. I see it.
Not that I need your help today.
Right. Apparently. Apparently, you're doing great today.
I know. I'm just in the zone. Auto zone. Right, I'm heading up top. Oh,
Oh,
dang it.
we ran out of time. All right, I'll make the server again. Where were we?
We were talking about inconsistent, or no, we were talking about last episodes and would we watch it?
Oh, okay. So, yeah. Comedy is great, serves up. Comedy is great. Ending was horrible.
Putting it slightly. Action! That was another really good thing, at least in the
All right.
very beginning. Like, in the first episode, there was a great little action scene that got Mark and I really excited. And it continued till the last episodes. Like, everything was just nice and fluid and very creative. Like, I gotta give him props for that. Like, one of the five episodes, she's fighting, Mirai is fighting, like, some type of cloth Yomu.
Right.
And it goes into the ground and just, like, turns invisible. So
Right.
creative.
I was gonna say I don't really have anything to add because I don't want to pay attention, but that's a lie.
I remember you paying very close attention to that one.
Well, then maybe I just don't remember until now.
Like her turning the sword upside down by liquefying her blood.
Exactly. The fights are amazing because of the fact that it's very creative. That's the one thing about like kind of fight scenes in anime. It feels kind of stiff.
And straightforward.
Yeah, but this one is like extremely dead. Ho ho ho! How am I? How are you not? Okay. You seem to be good at it today. I'm so seems to be an ass today.
Apparently.
Okay. Yeah, the creativity of the fights. When just the characters do things with their abilities that you wouldn't think of, and because of that, you kind of, you know, you wonder what they're gonna do next.
Yeah.
The God damn it. Need to have this. There. Alright. Kuriyama. The way she handles blood is not just sword. She rearranges it. She acts like as if she has the power in a long time, in which she has. An impression that some characters in other anime don't really give off.
Which is interesting, because she said that she needed practice at the very beginning.
Yeah. Just so fancy is good.
Can I just say Mitsuki came off kind of pathetic in the entire series?
Yeah, she didn't really have a lot of show-off time. She kind of was carried a lot. Which the only time she kind of showed off was with someone, and it gave off the impression that, you know, she's kind of a leech.
Michael Hex.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Which was kind of ironic, because in the very beginning, I assumed, like, she was, like, stronger than...
Same.
Akihito. Well, I assumed everyone was stronger than Akihito.
Until, you know.
Until, you know, badass mode activating.
God, that was good.
That was a great plot twist. I did not see that coming. Which, yeah.
Yeah, it was good that they made that kind of thing in which they're both monsters.
Yeah. Although, I don't get why he didn't defend himself earlier when he was saying, when Mirai was saying that you wouldn't understand I'm a monster. I was like, couldn't you have said something at that time?
No, that would have gave it a little too early. Yeah. I think they were just done for, like, a kind of a device in order to make you surprised. Thinking about it now, yeah, that's kind of illogical. Why didn't you just send it there and then?
Yeah.
Oh, but, shit.
But, hey.
You cheering for the Titans now?
Say what?
You're cheering for the Titans now?
Let's go, Titans. Let's go.
I ran into blades anyway.
Good job.
I kind of gave up when my blades kind of broke. I was like, fuck it, I'm not reloading.
Which, actually, I want to go back to the characters. They all have really good synergy now that I think about it.
Right. Like, yeah, none of them was actually kind of felt out of place.
In terms of the comedy, they all, like, really benefited from each other.
Mm-hmm. Like Ayaka getting money from those maid photos.
From Aki.
Yeah.
Probably the two that I liked together was Hirori.
Who? Excuse me?
The brother. I can't say the sister's name. No, I can't say
Hiromi?
Hiromi, yes. I like him. I like when he and Aki would talk. Because they seemed like friends.
What are you doing? I'm cold. My fingers are cold.
So why are they on my waist?
God. Just the back and forth is really great.
Especially like when they would talk about their fetishes.
God damn.
Just so many good things about that.
Yeah.
I cut your face. Your eyes should be blinded.
Oh, well, I give him a... Get wow, you're about to get grabbed as well.
Shh.
Damn it. Damn it. Apparently I can't kill him. Okay, you can have him. Good job, team.
Steal kill.
Good job, team.
Oh my gosh.
But now, yeah. On to the animation. Animation's great. I didn't notice anything that's bad. You?
Nope.
Artistically, it was great. It added to it. Like, you know how she was about to kill? Did you get grabbed?
I did.
Oh,
goodbye.
I'm sorry. A split second late! A split fucking second late. Alright, well, yeah, like, in the animation, you know how she was about to kill, quote-unquote, Aki?
Yeah.
And it was, like, kind of a black and white thing in the rain, and then she put down her glasses.
Oh, yeah.
That
was a very nice moment.
Saddening, but amazing.
Very saddening. I cried after I thought Aki was dead.
Especially after the preview. He's been dead for 2 weeks. I'm sorry?
Hey.
She's like a fucking troll.
Again, if it had ended there, it would have been a top 10. Or it would have been a 10 out of 10 for me.
Ah, not for me. I would have still had a bunch of fucking questions.
I might have had questions, but it would have... I still think it would have been one of my best ones. Or one of my favorite ones. It's one of the best. I made it.
Haha. What other points have we not touched on? Music! Sound, soundtrack, etc.
Did you notice much in the actual...
Well, I was gonna go through, like, opening and ending first, and then in terms of soundtrack.
Opening was fairly good, actually.
Yeah, opening was kind of... I have to go back and listen to it now. It wasn't catchy that I can't forget it, but it wasn't that annoying either that I wanted to skip it.
Yeah, I had no issues going through it.
Mm-hmm.
Especially with the actual animations during it.
Now, the ending.
There was an ending.
Both commented on how weird the transition was.
Oh,
a serious moment was going on, and then you'd hear kind of the ending. The way they do their ending was, as you're nearing the credits, you'll hear the first couple of notes of the ending song, and then it'll transition to credits.
Huge mood kill.
Yeah, there are times where it kind of is like, oh, okay, that sounds kind of nice. And it kind of makes sense with the scene currently, but there are times where it just kind of kills the mood. It's super serious, and then you get this lighthearted ending.
Yeah, like, it kind of just breaks in. You. Na, 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 na.
That was not Rosario Vampire.
No, not at all. But yeah, it was very out of place.
Also, scat out for me while I get some gas.
Okay. One over there.
That's specific.
I know, right? It's right there. I'm pointing at it.
Yeah?
Opposite side to your left.
Huh.
But,
so, yeah.
Also, can I just say, the main villain, it seemed like he was evil for the sake of being evil.
Right, his intentions was not really clear. Oh boy, am I. Oh boy. Someone passed me the weed, I'm high.
Like, it's the stereotypical, I want to destroy the Earth for no real reason. And, yeah, everybody hate me. Which, given, I hated him. But, there was no real reason as to why. I mean, if the Earth is destroyed, then you die as well.
Yeah, it wasn't kind of given any...
Which is a real shame when you compare it to Sakura's storyline, where it felt like she kind of had a motive as to why she was trying to kill Mirai.
What do you mean, kind of? Kind of have a motive?
Well, I still say it was
kind of I'd say that kind of
it
feeding
wasn't...
that thing... that halberd spear Mabob was a good motive to killing her.
Yeah, but... I don't know.
That's my opinion, though. Where the fuck is this two titans?
That's a very good question. I don't know. I don't know. I felt like Mork had not been done with her story.
Oh, shit. We've been going for 29 minutes.
Huh, that's pretty good.
You want to wrap it out here?
Yeah, I've discussed everything I've wanted to, unless you can think of anything.
Just want to end the game. One sec. We should end this with both of us alive rather than dead. Or one alive, one dead. So, we should get on top of the wall. It's a nice scenic view there.
Of, you know, evil titans.
Of everything breaking apart, yeah. So, Parker, overall thoughts, do you recommend it, and also your numerical grade for the series?
Do I recommend it? Yes, totally worth it. I would say stop after numbers.
Parker, we don't know each other well enough for you to hook me.
after 5 years, it's not good enough.
No.
I would say stop after the second sort of ending, because it is really good after that, or very good right there. However, given I wouldn't do the same thing, so. As for my numerical value.
Your what? Kind of started on there.
Shut up. I would probably give it a 7 out of 10.
7 out of 10?
Could have done better, but.
After we kind of finished. I don't know when. Oh, we said this, but we kind of gave it numerical grades at one point. It was not 7 out of 10, it was lower than that.
Yeah, but I still want to. The only reason I lowered it is because of the second to the last couple of episodes. That really killed it for me. But I remember it doing very well. I remember enjoying it a lot. So this is me saying, hey, this is still really good. It's just currently, eh.
Yeah. My opinions might change after the movie.
They could. But we haven't watched the movie, so this is my opinion.
Sure.
I'm Batman.
You could never be Batman.
Shut up, piss right. Again. Yours?
Well, overall thoughts. It is an amazing series. The kind of type in which I'm glad I went back to anime kind of thing. Because I'm not a huge anime person, unlike Parker is.
Hey, I watch all forms of entertainment, not just anime.
No, I meant in comparison to manga and anime. I'm extremely heavy on the manga thing rather than anime.
Yeah.
So I'm just... this is one of those series where... It reached my top 5. Easily.
I thought you were going to say it reached your soul.
This is the type of series in which I did not expect anything and was... Expectation was completely blown out. My non-existent expectation.
I was going to say, after K-Project, we didn't really have much of an expectation.
True enough. Alright, numerical value? 7.5, maybe 8. 7 to 8-ish is fair score. In which, it's not perfect, but it's still amazing.
Yeah, I agree.
And would I recommend it? Yes, watch the entire series. You might have a different opinion. You might be satisfied. There was an article in Kotaku, which gave them the impression that they were satisfied completely of Beyond the Boundary.
Eh.
It started off with, this movie will fill in plot holes that you wouldn't even notice in the first season.
I think we noticed.
Yeah, we both noticed, but it might just be our type of personality. So, you know, watch the entire series. It's great. Yeah, recommended for both of us. Highly recommended.
Alright.
Alright, well, thank you for watching. You suck at this game.
Screw you.